Thank you.
I'm glad I'm not here.
Especially with this year.
No.
They're just starting to
Thank you.
morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Welcome to St. John's. Welcome, everybody online. Pastor Rick is attending the Synod Convention this weekend, so we welcome Pastor John Swyers here to lead our worship this morning. Are there any announcements?
I have one.
Sally?
It didn't get on the calendar in the News Weekly, but stewardship is meeting at 11:30 on Thursday. If you want to come join us. And I think Natalie coming down the hall?
She's coming.
She has something that she wants to say.
Okay.
And there's still sign up for summer Sunday school and nursery up front as you're on your way out. While she's coming, I still have more. Next week, Pastor Rick's going to be at a firm. You get me next week. So that means he won't have his adult class, but I'm organizing like an intergenerational for families and everybody kind of Sunday school time down in the Sunday school room next week.
Natalie?
Okay. Pastor wanted me to mention a couple things while he's gone. Next Sunday is Hot Meal Ministry, and right after service we'll be preparing food to take out. So if anybody would like to help, let me know, because some of our regulars are going to be out of town, so we will need a little help with that. And then June 23rd is Compassion Sunday. They'll have the Make Your Own Sandwich Bar. We'll be collecting bug spray, wipes, and sunscreen for room in the inn. Also be collecting for Second Harvest, crackers, cornbread mix, pancake mix, cooking oil. And then we'll also have people here with a computer to help anybody who would like to sign up for the Thrive in Action Teams, so we can assist you with getting signed up. Pastor has a pretty hefty goal of getting as many Action Teams people signed up as we can, so we can do the ministry we're doing and possibly even grow it a little bit. And for your $20 investment, you know, we get $250 that we can use. So the more Action Teams we have, then we're not having to dip into, you know, any of our regular funds by having the Action Teams. So that'll be on the 23rd. So he wanted to make sure that everybody was aware of that. There you go.
Thank you, Natalie. Any other announcements? Okay. Mr. Swartz?
I always enjoy being here because I feel that I'm among friends, and what more can I say? I appreciate you all. Let's prepare our hearts for worship by participation in confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the God of manna, the God of miracles, the God of mercy.
Amen.
Drawn to Christ and seeking God's abundance, let us confess our sin. God, our provider, help us. It's hard to believe there is enough to share. We question your ways when they differ from the ways of the world in which we live. We turn to our own understanding rather than trusting in you. We take offense at your teachings and your ways. Turn us again to you. Where else can we turn? Share us the words of eternal life and feed us for the life of the world.
Amen.
Beloved people of God, in Jesus, the manna from heaven, you are fed and nourished. By Jesus, the worker of miracles, there is always more than enough. Through Jesus, the bread of life, you are shown God's mercy. You are forgiven and loved into abundant life.
Amen.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above, for the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Defend us, gracious Lord.
Pray. Almighty and ever-living God, throughout time you free the oppressed, heal the sick, and make whole all that you have made. Look with compassion on the world, wounded by sin, and by your power restore to a wholeness of life. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Be seated.
As part of the first reading, part of the Ten Commandments, these verses instruct the Israelites to keep the Sabbath. The Israelites are to rest and they to allow their slaves, their livestock, and the foreigners living among them to do the same. They were once slaves, and so they are to treat their own slaves justly. Deuteronomy, the 5th chapter, beginning with the 12th verse. Observe the Sabbath day and keep it holy, as the Lord your God commanded you. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath to the Lord your God, and you shall not do any work. You, or your son or your daughter, or your male servant, or your female slave, or your ox or your donkey, or any of your livestock, or the resident alien in your towns, so that your male and female slave may rest as well as you. Remember that you are a slave in the land of Egypt, and the Lord your God brought you out with his mighty hand and an outstretched arm. Therefore, the Lord your God commanded you to keep the Sabbath day. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We will read the psalm responsively by whole verse. The congregation reads the bold print. Psalm 81. Sing with joy to God our strength, and raise a loud shout to the God of Jacob.
Raise the song and sound general, the merry harp and the lyre.
Blow the ram's horn at the new moon, and at the full moon, the day of our feast.
For this is a statute for Israel, a law of the God of Jacob.
God laid it as a solemn charge upon Joseph, going out over the land of Egypt, where I heard a voice I did not know.
I eased your shoulder from the burden, your hands were set free from the grave digger's basket.
You called on me in trouble, and I delivered you. I answered you from the secret place of thunder, and tested you at the waters of Meribah.
Hear, O my people, and I will admonish you. O Israel, if you would but listen to me.
There shall be no strange god among you. You shall not worship a foreign god.
I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt. Open your mouth wide, and I will fill it.
In today's second reading, when we carry out God's ministry, we do not do for our glory, but for the sake of Jesus Christ, whom we proclaim as Lord. The power of ministry comes from God, not us, so that we persevere no matter what, trusting in God's power and promises at work through us. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. We do not proclaim ourselves. We proclaim Jesus Christ as Lord, and ourselves as your slaves for Jesus' sake. For it is the God who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," who has shown in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. But we have this treasure in clay jars, so that it may be made clear that this extraordinary power belongs to God and does not come from us. We are afflicted in every way, but not crushed, perplexed, but not driven to despair, persecuted, but not forsaken, struck down, but not destroyed, always carrying in our body the death of Christ, so that the life of Jesus may also be made visible in our bodies. For while we live, we are always being given up to death for Jesus' sake, so that the life of Jesus may be made visible in our mortal flesh. So death is at work in us, but life in you. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the gospel.
Alleluia. Your word, O Lord, is truth. Sanctify us in the truth. Alleluia. Jesus challenges the prevailing interpretation of what is lawful on the Sabbath and tells his critics that the Sabbath was made for humankind, not the other way around. Healing the man with a withered hand is work that cannot wait until the next day. The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
One Sabbath, Jesus was going through the grain fields, and as they made their way, his disciples began to pluck heads of grain. The Pharisees said to him, "Look, why are you doing that? What is not lawful on the Sabbath?" And he said to them, "Have you never read what David did when he and his companions were hungry and in need of food? He entered the house of God when Abiathar was high priest and ate the bread of the presence, which is not lawful for any but the priest to eat. And he gave some to his companions. Then he said to them, 'The Sabbath was made for humankind, and not humankind for the Sabbath. So the Son of Man is Lord even of the Sabbath.' Again he entered the synagogue, and a man was there who had a withered hand. They watched him to see whether he would cure him on the Sabbath, so that they might accuse him. And he said to the man who had the withered hand, 'Come forward.' Then he said to them, 'Is it lawful to do good or to do harm on the Sabbath, to save life or to kill?' But they were silent. He looked around at them with anger. He was grieved at their hardness of heart. And he said to the man, 'Stretch out your hand.' He stretched it out, and his hand was restored. The Pharisees went on and immediately conspired with the Herodians against him, how to destroy him." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Are there children today? It's cool. Okay, come on. Hey, you're brave. Hey, you're cool. Now, I'm going to ask you a question, but, you know, if you don't know the answer to it, it's okay with me, because sometimes I don't know what it is. Why are you here? Oh, wow.
What did he say?
He said, to listen to God.
Oh.
That is neat. Obviously, something is really taking hold of you for you to answer that way. I wish I could say that I was the same when I was your age, but I was an absolute hellion in Sunday school, and my sister had to haul me out of the Sunday school classroom when I was crying and screaming, and I didn't have the wisdom that you do at this age. You're here, and it's Sunday morning, and this is a place where you learn about God. And you're young, you're not of my age yet, and you'll get there someday, but take your time. You've got a whole life in front of you, and it's a really cool kind of thing. And one of the things that's going to happen to you is that you're going to learn more and more about God in this place. And you're going to see also that when you, if you haven't already seen it, and you're smart, you're also going to see when you go out there into the world on the other side of these windows here,
that God is going to be with you there too. And you're going to remember the things that you learned here, and you're going to begin to learn that even in the midst of the world, you come to a knowledge of God. It's called Sabbath. It is taking time out to allow God to speak to us. And Chief, you are well on your way. Thank you for being here with me.
Get my balance again.
That was impressive.
Grace be unto you and peace from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm ancient in age, but really a kid at heart. And I can remember when I was growing up that Sabbath was intertwined into the culture in a way it is not now. Sundays were Sundays then, and they are not now. But then the world has changed. When I was growing up, gas was being rationed, and you couldn't go any place anyhow. So I remember my sister balancing me on the bicycle as she rode down the street to the pharmacy that was open and got that precious pint of ice cream, which was divided five ways when we had Sunday dinner. And after World War II, subdivisions began to spring up all over the place, and supermarkets came into being, and Walmart and the big box stores and all that good kind of stuff. And we think, oh my, everything is ruined. But I really wonder if that is what Sabbath is all about. And Jesus tells us differently in our gospel for this morning. We see the disciples moving through the field and seeing some grain, not exactly the kind of snack food we might choose for ourselves today, but they began to eat it. And immediately a Pharisee said to them, in essence, you're eating on the Sabbath and you're breaking the law. I don't think that fellow would have survived very well at the drive-in line in Wendy's if he were there this morning. But that's another story. Jesus said, look, was the Sabbath made for man, or was man made for the Sabbath? And the answer is the former. The Sabbath is made for humankind, for you and for me. Well, what is Sabbath anyhow? Is it the Sunday morning thing here? Yes, it is. And to be sure, this is the hour in the week when the community gathers. And that is an important hour because we come corporately together to be refreshed in God's word so that we can be comfy? No. So that we are equipped to serve in the world. That's why we're here. But God's activity of Sabbath is not restricted to this place, nor do we always have to be gathered in community to experience that.
or to take advantage of Sabbath. Now, when I was growing up, my dad would work 5 days a week traveling from Scarsdale to Manhattan and back, and he would run for bus every morning for the 10 of 8 bus, and he would come back beat at 6 o'clock at night, and if he was lucky, he would have gotten the 502 train out of Grand Central. If he wasn't lucky, he had to wait till 5:15. And on Saturdays, it was mow the lawn, do this, do that. And on Sundays, it was usually crash with the morning paper, because he sent my sister to Sunday school with me, and he always said, there's somebody more deserving than I am, and he should have my church, he should have my seat in church. You know, that was a real cop-out on his part. But, you know, Dad had the heart of a servant, too. And he didn't dig corporate worship in the church growing up, and neither did I, for that matter. That's another story. But anyhow, Dad was an artist, and he took a course, in one of those night adult courses in the high school, and he renewed his painting. And everybody else in his advertising agency would go out for a day of golf. And Dad was not a golfer. Instead, he'd pick up his palette of paints, his little easel, and he'd go off on some remote side of the golf course, and he would paint. And he'd come home, and he'd usually have some kind of a landscape there. Dad was a servant and was always really kind to others. And I like to think that this was his kind of Sabbath moment. To be sure, it doesn't take the place of communal worship or what our responsibility is. I'm just saying, there are other ways of approaching Sabbath. One of the things I do is I walk down someplace before worship to kind of just, you know, let it all relax for a few minutes. Now, this morning I went down to Two Rivers Greenway, and I parked up near the wave pool there, and I walked underneath the bridge, and I walked over the Cumberland River. And I'm looking at some signs there. If I can remember it correctly, there's signs up on the side, up on the embankment, just before you get to the bridge. Strength, courage, depth, spirit. Whew. Somebody was experiencing Sabbath in some way, shape, or form when they put that up there. I think that's really cool. God comes to us at different moments. Don Harris and I spar with each other. We have that. There are two people that just come together and we have fun. And for me, when Don comes in the room, you know, that's a time to relax and just kind of cut loose and enjoy the abundant life. There's something more than meets the eye. And I'm sure it would be the same with a lot of you as you and I would come to know each other. So Sabbath, regardless of what it is a time for us to re-equip, to re-gear. Yesterday, I was at the ordination of Deacon Tabitha Sankos of St. Anselm Episcopal Church, where I sometimes officiate in North Nashville. And Tabitha now has the ability to distribute the sacraments, so I'm headed right there from here. But one of the things that the pastor said there was, as a deacon, You are called to be a prism and reflect God's light. And you, as deacons, are called upon to do this. Well, ordination to me is, yes, it's set apartness, but you know, we are all prisms, one to another. And we are to reflect God's light. Now, it's not always easy to do. Sometimes it's difficult. In our second lesson for this morning, we heard St. Paul's words. And he said, the light shines out of the darkness. Think about that. Darkness, light. Imagery used a lot in the New Testament, in the Gospel of John, and elsewhere. But then St. Paul goes on to say that we're not always find ourselves at an easy place in this world. He says, we're afflicted, but not crushed. We're perplexed, but we're not driven to despair. We're persecuted, but we're not forsaken. We're struck down, but we're not destroyed. We carry the death of Jesus within us, but then we also carry the light of Jesus in us. And one of the things that equips us to move from darkness to light in a continuum, we got our good days and we got our bad days. But the thing that enables us to move in our continuum from darkness to light is this thing that we call Sabbath. And it's something that we can see every day in every place. And as we grow in God's grace, and as we grow in God's word, and as we partake of sacrament, it begins to take root in us. Psalm 1 is a psalm that talks about being rooted like trees instead of blowing about like leaves on a windy day in the fall. And so it is. And sometimes it gets a little bit tricky. And sometimes things come upon us that are totally unexpected. I have a 16 and a half foot runabout, little speedboat that I haven't used for 20 years. But if I were to take the thing into the Cumberland River and I would drop the anchor, the boat would not go upstream or downstream, hopefully. But then if I sat on the stern and I looked over to my left and I saw the skyline of downtown Nashville and I started to read a book or something, which I wouldn't do because of the traffic in the Cumberland, but then I could look out the same side of the boat 5 minutes later and I'd be looking at Nissan Stadium. You know, it just, the whole landscape changes around us and we've got to be flexible. And we are called upon to be flexible. I remember when I was a chaplain years ago, I'd been on the road for 2 weeks solid, bounced from Milwaukee to Albany, New York, to Hartford, Connecticut, back down to Washington, D.C., and finally home. And I got home on a Friday night. I thought, well, I need to check and see what's going on in the institution. And I walked into the deputy warden's office and I said, "What's new?" And he said, "You're not going to believe this, but the warden was up in Sparta with his inmate who took care of his home, and that was done in those days. And he said the warden broke his arm, had to be carried by ambulance to Nashville, and his wife left, and his inmate is up there with his mother in Sparta." Well, I didn't think that the inmate was going to escape. Curtis was just, he was a top-notch human being. But I also understood that an inmate unsupervised, or at least without being in the vicinity of a TDOC official, it was not a good kind of scene. So I jumped into the car and I was up in White County retrieving those folks in no time flat. At the deputy warden's insistence, had to turn around. I was looking forward to a Saturday and Sunday at home, you know, kind of catching up from the 2 weeks, but that's not the way it turned. Sunday morning, I was driving back from White County to Lauderdale County with my passengers with me. It goes around without saying. In this particular day and age, we don't know what's going to happen next. It's a polarized set of circumstances. And what is the answer? The answer is the same answer that Paul gave years ago. Take time for Sabbath. Be re-equipped. Be regenerated. And be transformed by the renewal of your mind so that you may do what is the will of God. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Thank you.
Let us together confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The peace of the living Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share the peace. The peace. Before the triune God to pray for our communities, ourselves, and our world. Guide your church to expressions of faith that bring rest and release. Teach your faithful people to be attentive to the spiritual, physical, and societal weariness of our neighbors, that we proclaim your grace through tangible acts of mercy and justice. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Keep us mindful of the rhythms of nature as the days lengthen and the seasons shift towards summer. Grant relief to areas facing flooding or drought, and bring favorable weather for the flourishing of crops, gardens, and orchards. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Where there is affliction in our world, bring healing. Where world leaders are perplexed, bring clarity of vision. Give a spirit of discernment to political advisors, institutional researchers, economic analysts, and all vocations that inform the war, that inform the work of governments and policymakers. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Provide wholeness and respite to all who are weary, those who struggle in any way, and those who care for them. Strengthen first responders and healthcare workers in their times of exhaustion or frustration. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Stir our hearts towards abundant generosity among neighbors who experience hunger and food insecurity. Bless feeding ministries and community food efforts, especially community gardens, farmers markets, food pantries, and little free pantries. Open both our hearts and our tables. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
We pray especially for Tabitha, as her ordination of deacon has taken place. Guide her, help her, love her as she continues to grow in ministry. We pray for Gil, who has had difficulty with his leg and suffers infection and pain. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
We remember the communion of saints whose lives made visible the saving life of Jesus Christ. Guide us by their example to embody the treasure of your love for the sake of our world until we come to our final rest in you. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Receive our prayers, O God, and come quickly to our aid through the power of the Spirit and the love of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending voices.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and gave it for all to eat. Take and eat, this is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. Again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. do this for the remembrance of me. Let us pray our Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you.
Come, the table is prepared for all, and all means all.
All.
The body of Christ given for you. The body of Christ given for you. Sally, the body of Christ given for you. 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 the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen. Amen.
Bread of life, we have received from your table more than we could ever ask. As you have nourished us in this meal, now strengthen us to love the world with your own life. In your name we pray.
Amen.
The blessing of God who provides for us, feeds us, and journeys with us be upon you now and forever.
Amen.
Thank you.
the body of Christ for the sake of the world.
Thanks be to God.
Okay.
Can we get back in?
I got it.